Hey guys, if you're into using liquid applications of soil amendments, fertilizers, and herbicides like I do, then you're going to want to keep watching this video because I'm going to show you about a simple change to your backpack sprayer that will change everything. So as you can see behind me, I'm one of those lawn guys that likes to put down all my products as much as possible as a liquid. I feel like you get a much more even, consistent coverage by putting down a liquid product versus a granular. You can also dial in more specific needs to your lawn by just changing some of the mixing ratios before you put them into your backpack sprayer. This doesn't mean that I don't use granular products, because there's plenty of products that I still put down over the course of the year using my rotary spreader. So the change to your sprayer that I was referring to is the sprayer tip that you use for your backpack sprayer. This is a TeeJet Air Induction Tip. It's designed to manage drift and get the most out of the product that you apply to your lawn. What it does is, through different chambers inside the tip, it actually introduces air into the liquid droplets so that they're larger and they fall directly to the ground and they don't drift off into the air or evaporate like the stock tip that probably comes with your backpack sprayer. So I live in a coastal area and it seems like Murphy's Law. Whenever I start loading up a product into my backpack sprayer, some sort of breeze starts picking up in my area, and I notice that as I start spraying, I can see like a mist of the product being blown into areas that either I don't want it to get on or just in general going, you know, in different directions. These tips will prevent that from happening, and it'll also give you a wider spray path so that you can get your product done faster. So I took a couple of videos here showing the difference between the stock sprayer tip that came with my sprayer and the new TeeJet air induction tip. One of these videos here will show the difference in the spray pattern. There is a slight increase in width in the spray pattern with the new TeeJet tip, and that will help you get down your product faster. The second video here, I'm trying to show the difference in the drift management. I'm not sure if it's going to show up as clear on the screen as I was expecting. I was trying to get the daylight in just the right location so that you could see the difference. But my point of this was to show that the original stock tip, when sprayed at full pressure, has very fine droplets that seem to, you know, get carried by the breeze and go in places where you're not intending. The TeeJet tip has larger droplets and therefore it drops right to the ground and goes exactly where you want, getting the product where you need it to be. So I picked this tip up for about $10 on Amazon. There's really not much to it. There's no moving parts. It installs exactly the same as the stock tip that comes with your backpack sprayer. It's just a little bit longer because it has more to it as far as what it does before the liquid actually leaves the sprayer end. So, like I've said in other videos, if you haven't already picked up a backpack sprayer, I highly recommend you spend a few extra dollars and get yourself a battery-operated backpack sprayer. It keeps the pressure up consistently without any effort. There's nothing wrong with a pump sprayer, it just takes a little bit more effort to keep that pressure up. The pressure is important because if the pressure gets too low, your fan spray pattern will decrease and you won't get the same amount of coverage. I still use my pump sprayer. I just tend to use it for more stronger herbicides that I don't want mixing with the everyday soil amendment or fertilizer products that I use with my battery operated sprayer. So this company TeeJet makes a wide variety of spray tips ranging from commercial to residential use. I will leave a link below to the exact product that I am referring to that I got on Amazon. So if you're into using liquid applications of fertilizers and different products on your lawn, I highly recommend making this small $10 investment. It will really reassure that the products that you're applying go where you want them to go, and so that you could take advantage of all the nutrients that are impacted with this. Thanks for watching, guys. As always, if you like what you see, give me a thumbs up and click that subscribe button so you can keep up with my new content.